When you think about Latin America, I want you to start thinking that we have so much talent there. So I want you to think through all this presentation that Latin America is really creative. I don't know how many of you know the terminology of orange economy. Can you raise your hand? Orange economy started from 2013 with the former president today of Colombia, Iván Duque, when he was working at the Inter-American Development Bank. And the orange economy is an economy who's based on creativity, that is able to produce products and services that are tied with intellectual property. So what I mean, basically, the orange economy is able to generate jobs, to create value, and to generate a social impact. These are the three things that you must know when you talk about the orange economy. If we translate that into numbers, we are talking about 29.5 million workers around the globe that is in that economy, that represent 3.3% of the GDP. And for Latin America, that means 2.2% of the GDP. But probably still you have been thinking, well, what is that sectors that are part of the orange economy? We have more than 37 sectors in the orange economy. We are talking about the fashion industry, the video games, the software development, the film industry, and so many others that I am going to illustrate through the presentation. When you ask a person that is in that field, What we hear is, well, I would love to produce amazing production for Broadway, but are you a business person, not only creative? They say, no. We are no business person, and we are not a startup, a company at all. So this is the pattern that we hear all the time that is coming from the creative perspective. But what they don't know is most of them have something in common, that they are able to create amazing companies. And for that reason, some of them are very great entrepreneurs. If we come back to the numbers, when I'm talking about this kind of company, we can see Mexico is leading that in Latin America, followed by Colombia. So there is a lot of exporters of creative goods in our countries. You can see a publication there, you can download, and you can see how every single country in Latin America has some part of that equation. Design, I don't know how many of you are designers here, but design is something that is exploding these days. 20% of the company invested in venture capitals in the last 10 years were funded by designers. And we see that pattern in Latin America. This is really important that we bring this to here today, because designers not only leading as a CEO or creating this company, they are also very attractive to venture capitals, but for companies, regular companies, that would like to have this different perspective of thinking to actually innovate in their companies. So now I am going to give you some ideas of that companies that are from Latin America. One of them is from Colombia. It's called Voice Bunny. This company, basically what they did, they create the biggest database of voice talent in the globe. They have this idea, probably if you think about 7 years ago, you were thinking like, a talent, voice, I don't know, that doesn't sound that sexy. But today, this is amazing. Voice is all over the places. So what they did is they innovate in the process. They create a software with artificial intelligence. And when, you know, in Latin America, when they start working with all this talent, they figured it out that this process from a commercial producer or radio producer to actually look for that voice they were looking for took approximately 3 months. With this platform, all this process, reduced to 10 minutes. And this is really great. But the most important is the talent that is in that database. And even though they are not selected as the final for the commercial or for the radio commercial, they get paid. So this is something really important in Latin America. The second company is from Mexico. It's called Machina. when they start working in this company, they wanted to create this a line of clothing where a DJ can touch themselves and actually mix their music. But they realized that many of the products they were creating were so appealing to with people with disabilities. So now you can see how these companies are bleeding to other sectors like health, like education. So creativity right now is really powerful. Another company from Colombia is Dynamo. Dynamo is one of the first companies in Latin America that are able to create original content for Netflix in Spanish. When they, approximately 10 years ago, when they pitched that idea to Endeavor, Endeavor didn't pay attention to that. They were not sure about it, if they wanted to, you know, to highlight this company. But what they did is they were curious about the production company in Colombia. So they hired some group of people from MIT, and they developed a study. And this study, because of that, they changed the law in Colombia. So in 2005, in Colombia, they were able to produce 9 films. In 2015, they were producing 36 films. So the law helped Colombians to have this booming in that industry. So now, obviously, Dynamo is an amazing company, and they are creating more content in Spanish. Actually, yesterday was a news about the Brazilian market. They are creating more than 36 original content to Netflix today. Some people think about theater, and they are thinking about, well, probably I can see this place in New York or in Paris. But Buenos Aires is the city that has more theaters in the world. And this is where it was more theatric. Theatric is a platform like Netflix, focus on plays. And what is amazing about this company is they are giving access to people that are not able to go or pay for that play. So we see this company growing very fast and taking a market like schools in Dominican Republic and any other cities on the in the world. Probably you are thinking that all these examples that I just gave you are related to technology, but when you think about the orange economy, not necessarily all the companies that we are talking about are technology companies. So we have this one from Chile called Elemental, and this company is based on building houses in a different way. They do architecture from beautiful to practical, and they build the houses. You can see in the second photo with the space, they are building houses with that extra space. So what that means is people that are buying the houses, they can actually build a house when they get better income or when they have the possibility to do it. And they have been blooming in Chile and in another part of the Latin American market. Also, the luxury companies are something that is blooming in Latin America. This is Mola Sasa from Guatemala. They are working with the indigenous community. All of them now are the designer of this company. And we have another example like Hilo Sagrado from Colombia, who they are working with indigenous community between Venezuela and Colombia. But the most important thing is they can get access to water and energy in that communities. And this one, I wanted to leave you for the last one for the example that I brought, is a Bolivian doctor who is building something really unique. No machine in the world can actually mimic what they are doing. They are taking the Aymara women, the indigenous community, you know, with the ancestral knowledge to build this little tiny thing that I don't know how you can call that, but they use that for open surgery for babies. So how you can see how we connect the culture, the creativity, and the new solution that we need in our region. All these examples, we have more than 50 from all over Latin America. You can found it in that publication. They are in English and Spanish. And this is, I invite all of you to check the amazing company that we have there. So remember when I say that most of the creative people don't feel that they are business person. So we were really intrigued about that. And last year we published a book with the Failure Institute from Mexico. Who are these creative entrepreneurs? What they do, where they went to college, how they are happy, how they build their companies, and all of that to understand better and to actually make sure that we empower them. So the first thing that we create was a profile, and I am going to give you some of the information that you can find in that publication. So the age. Most of us think, obviously, because in Latin America we always look this United States as an example of the entrepreneurial community, and we have this idea that all our entrepreneurs are like 20, 25 years old, but the reality is that our entrepreneurs in Latin America are 35 years old. And this is also very important for investors to understand that we probably are kind of different, but I think in Silicon Valley, the entrepreneurs are not that young. Also, the three causes of the failure in the creative communities are the same one with any entrepreneur. They have bad planification for the finance. They don't know their market. What we found is they fell in love with their ideas and the concept and their products, but they don't understand their market. You ask them, to whom you're going to sell this product? Who are your competitors? They are not able to actually say anything. So this is a pattern that we see over and over and over. And this can be an opportunity for universities to take over and to teach that concept or the community of the entrepreneurs community. And the last one is the cash flow. But the good news is when we compare the entrepreneurial community from the technology aspect to the creative aspect, we see that 13% more of women in the orange economy entrepreneurship community. And this is something really important because how you can see, it's difficult sometimes to find these women in our communities. And when we do all these events and panels, the media probably has the same problem. It's hard to find who are these next leader, women leaders. So I invite all of you that are here or are part of LatAm, Canada, to actually, you know, be a little bit more brave and take care and launch their company, because we wanted to see these creative women to be the next CEO in Latin America too. 90% of the professionals that were part of this survey, they had somehow some education, and for us was really impressive, the level of education they have. But when we asked them, how do you learn how to do business, or how do you learn how to build your company, they say they learn from the gut. They don't have really a clue how they were doing it, and this is not bad, but I think it's an amazing opportunity that we think about how in the university we can bring together the creative sectors, the ones that are in architecture, the ones that study video game, film, advertisement, etc., to the business side of the company and vice versa. But this is something that is not only happening in the university levels. This is also something that is happening in our government. If you think about Minister of Culture, probably it's not talking to the other side of the business side, or the Minister of Economic, or the one that is leading with entrepreneurial ecosystem. So we need to put these two people talking. We need to pull these two environments together, because I think there is when we are going to actually see grow this ecosystem. These companies are like any other companies in Latin America. They stayed alive for 2 years and 4 months. So this is nothing new for all, but I think it's important we take in consideration that many of these companies will fail. And with the Failure Institute, we create this equation to understand the health of the companies. What we realize is that the health was not that good, but we see a pattern of some of these companies. For example, we saw that people that have company with more than 5 employees were in a better position. We see that the companies that have the CEO, you know, older than 35, getting to the 50s, were in better position. So there are so many factors that we can, you know, you can analyze that later, but it's something that you can take in consideration to build a better company. At the beginning of this talk, I talk about the design aspect, how you can see here in all this, the design, which is the green one, is the biggest chunk of the equation from all these surveys. So this is important that we think how we can empower designers to actually build these companies and be successful. But there is one sector that is the surprise one, and this is the video game industry. How you can see is the sector that is growing the fastest in the world. And you can see the 13.5% in the last star. This is us. This is Latin America. We are the second region that is growing faster in the entire world. So this is something that we have to think about, how we can actually connect these video game studios with other investors and market. We are going to publish in 2 months a mapping of all video game houses on Latin America. And we want you to know who are these talent behind these companies and what kind of product they can offer to the Asian, Canadian, and other markets. I saw this morning a lot of investors and people are talking about investment. I want you to see that because the last one is the seed investment that these people get in their companies. And the fourth one is the banks. So there is a lot of opportunities to actually learn how we can understand this new sector that is growing, the one in the orange economy. And it has to be both ways. We as a creator need to learn how to actually pitch these ideas to the investors, but also the investor need to understand better this market. And in the same way, the banks has to find a way. I know we don't see banks doing all this, you know, investing in entrepreneurs, but I think financial instruments need to change. And I see that there is a willing to do it. We just launched fund for Colombia with Banco Dex. So they are looking in a different way to actually support the startups that are coming from the orange economy. And this is something that can happen in many other sectors. For next year, we are going to have more than 20,000 co-working spaces around the world. And when we ask these startups, where do they work? You can see that co-working spaces were 7% only. For us, this is a signal that these new co-working spaces brand and are growing need to be more affordable for our entrepreneurs. But also, we have to realize that many of these people that were in the survey didn't work 100% in their companies. So this is why you see that most of them work from home and from the office. Some people think, you know, that because you're in the creative sector, you're happier or not happier. Well, what we see here is that money doesn't have any correlation with happiness for the creators. So even though the wellness and happiness have an impact in productivity, money was not the case. But what we can say is that people working in visual art, scenic art, the editorial world are happier. And the people that are working in consultancy services for accounting, the legal aspect of the company, and advertisement were the ones that were a little bit more unhappy. So, but we can take 4 things from that conclusion, is that even if you're building a startup, if you're a big company, a small company, you have to figure it out that the future of job is changing, and we need to make sure that when we attract this talent, we have a variety of work for them. We can have a they can have a high degree of autonomy, and they have a space to learn new things. This is what people actually are looking for to work in this company of the future. Well, you can see all this information here in this publication. It's in English and in Spanish. And we have more information about the orange economy from different aspects. We work with the Institute of the Future from Silicon Valley to create some trends. And there is the original book from the former president of Colombia, Iván Duque, the one on the orange. We have all the numbers from all the countries from Latin America. And the one in the middle are all related to entrepreneurship and creativity. So thank you so much, and I hope you can invest in Latin America, and we are more attracted to you now understanding the concept of orange economy.